Everybody on the floor now. Some people have everything and other people don't. But everything don't mean a thing if it ain't the thing you want. Express yourself.
The nominees for Best Station are Two Local Radio, Storm FM, Stream Radio, Mix DJ Radio, Sparks Radio, Pure Music 24/7, Keepin' It Radio, B97 FM, We Funk Radio, Jump Radio UK, Electric Couch, The Sir Walter Jones Show, Earl Hall, I Am a Superwoman Radio, Jerry Royce Live, Vibes Live Radio, Robin Lynn.
end of reflection. This story is from the New York Times. I'm Eric Byrne. You're listening to Newsbeat Radio. There are many moments throughout my average day that, lacking print reading material in a previous era, were once occupied by thinking or observing my surroundings, walking or waiting somewhere, riding the subway, lying in bed unable to sleep, or before mustering the energy to get up. Now, though, I often find myself in these situations, picking up my phone to check a notification, browse and read the internet, text, use an app, or listen to audio, or, on rare occasions, engage in an old-fashioned telephone call. The last remaining place I'm guaranteed to be alone with my thoughts is in the shower. Finding moments to engage in contemplative thinking has always been a challenge since we're distractible, said Nicholas Carr, author of The Shallows. But now that we're carrying these powerful media devices around with us all day long, those opportunities become even less frequent, for the simple reason that we have this ability to distract ourselves constantly. Neuroplasticity, or the brain's ability to change due to technological use, is a hot topic. Usually the tone is alarmist, though sometimes it's optimistic. Take video games. One study revealed improvements in memory and focus for older adults when playing a video game. Take video games. One study revealed improvements in memory and focus for older adults when playing a simple road racing game. In another study, playing Super Mario 64 was observed to yield increases in gray matter in regions of the brain associated with memory, planning, and spatial navigation. But these cognitive abilities are distinct from mentally sequestered rumination. In a world in which a phone or computer is rarely more than arm's length away, are we eliminating introspection at times that may have formerly been conducive to it? And is the depth of that reflection compromised because we have retrained ourselves to seek out the immediate gratification of external stimuli? A few neuroscientific studies reveal the extent to which we are dependent on our electronic devices and suggest how, in doing so, we may be impairing our reflective abilities. A 2015 paper in the journal PLOS-ONE measured smartphone use via an app from participants ages 18 to 33 and also asked them to report their estimates. If you are awake for 16 hours, turning on or checking your phone 85 times means doing so about once every 11 minutes and doesn't account for internet use or a computer. And 5.05 hours is over 30% of the day. What might be the effect on reflection of this compulsive behavior? In 2010, researchers led by Dr. Stephen Fleming at the Wellcome Trust Center for Neuroimaging at University College London published a paper in the journal Science in which they correlated introspective ability with the amount of gray matter in the prefrontal cortex. Introspective ability was defined for the study as the accuracy of measuring one's own performance on a visual perception task, a sign of metacognition or thinking about thinking. Using this information about the prefrontal cortex, Brian Maniscalco and Hakwon Lau published a paper in Neuroscience of Concussions in 2015 that measured introspective ability while subjects were either able to focus on one task or distracted by a difficult second task. Being distracted by the second task didn't hurt actual performance on the first task, but it did impair the subject's ability to be introspective, again, by accurately self-reporting how they did. The finding supports previous widespread evidence that multitasking leads to lower cognitive performance.
This is Lindell Williams, CEO of Hater Free Entertainment. Shout out to my girl, Robin Lynn. Thanks for keeping the vibes live. To keep it going. Oh.
Yo, 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 este es Locheta. En esta vuelta, traje la vaina aventura que asusta. Pra, 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 pra. Yo, 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 este es Locheta. En esta vuelta traje la vaina aventura que asusta. Pra, pra, pra. Pa' la secuencia nocturna. Rompiendo a todo en si boquita, uno a uno. Date en frita desde Saturno. Es pa' los tigres del turno nocturno. Yeah. Yeah. Lo viste, te fuiste a pique, salpique. Nada más te queda, caime atrás. Coge el Twitter. Tú sabes que los cuáquen, estoy controlando esto. Puesto pa' los molletos, sigo vivo y suelto. Rapesao, champion sound, mañiña, collaboration. Yo, fiel a mi vaina como un terrorista hasta el sol de hoy.
Cuidado, homeboy, que ahí voy.
DJ Alfa, el más niña number one. Tu frecuencia no mina, lo intubito mientras.
El blanquito cotadísimo, bajo loquísimo.
Sin mentol, con alcohol en español.
Frecuencia nocturna. El blanquito cotadísimo, bajo loquísimo.
DJ Alfa, el cambio, que entra rompiendo. Frecuencia nocturna, normal, con la vaina fortimal. Vamos arriba.
Ay. El blanquito cotadísimo, bajo loquísimo. Entra desde atrás con un rap y el funky. El blanquito totaísimo, bajo loquísimo. Entra desde atrás con un rap y el funky. El blanquito totaísimo, bajo loquísimo. Entra desde atrás con un rap bien funky. El blanquito totaísimo, bajo loquísimo.
Yo, yo. MC Malco mío, tienen el casco vacío y el cerebro vencido, no da más que disco aburrido. Otros somos rapesados, con el casco fundido, y este estilo es Rambo sin gaguear, que somos un lío. Cuando mango y tiro, con esto vi del diablo, eso es lo mío, muestran que no me he cambiado de bando. Sigo activo, ahora con DJ Alfa, estate quieto, cuando rapeo no vaya y te confunda con un mama huevo de esto. Esto es rap en español, sin mentor, ponme la mano arriba. Alcohol, ginecología, el peje que manada o el chivo que mamea, como sea, don Ochea, el fuerte no te lleve y dale pa' allá sin mente al final. Lo que saben son ustedes, inventan con estos flow cuadrado al chel, el papá de los pollitos, todito, quedan doblados como un codito, y eso que estoy viejo y no practico.
El blanquito totaísimo, bajo loquísimo. Entra desde atrás con un rap bien funky. El blanquito totaísimo, bajo loquísimo. Entra desde atrás con un rap bien funky. El blanquito totaísimo, bajo loquísimo. Entra desde atrás con un rap bien funky. El blanquito totaísimo, bajo loquísimo. Entra desde atrás con un rap yujizo. Y esto es estilo que preñan de mellizo.
Yo, rap pesado, jugando sucio, directo y en vivo de la Cueva Estudio. DJ Alfa con el boom, 8 Sapiens coming soon, Mighty 8.
Favorito, lo admito, y no soy portador de mil amigos, no. Y los que tengo solo son virtuales. Y se podría decir que mi soledad y yo somos amantes. Pero no soy solitario, quejándome de todo. Soy un protagonista, actuando como lo hacen todos. Me rodeo de locos, hipócritas y mentirosos. A eso es lo que yo le llamo un mundo de locos. Pero ¿quién soy para juzgarlos o juzgarme yo solo? Si cometo errores y me patina el coco. Pero vivo feliz en mi mundo desastroso. Me da felicidad en el espejo ver mi rostro. Me gustan los fracasos, yo lloro la victoria. Me gusta caer y levantarme, es mi gloria. Y no hay derrota más mala que el rendirse. Por eso aunque caigas de la vida hay que reírte. Si quieres sentir lo que yo siento, si yo pudiera entender pudiera entender lo que habla el viento. Y no entiendo la vida, es algo inalcanzable. Luego miro el cielo y las estrellas son distantes. En un solo instante ella se esfuma, dejando un espacio vacío junto a la luna. Mi inteligencia es poca y me invade la ignorancia. Y confundo la tristeza con los días de nostalgia. La vida es difícil y la despedida es dura. Pero más dura la muerte, la realidad es cruda. Si tuviera un deseo sería la muerte. Perderme en un sueño que nunca me despierten. Ahí donde todo neutral es blanco y negro. En donde las lágrimas inundan un desierto. Caen las estrellas al caer la noche. Como cayeron mis lágrimas encima de su cofre. No hubo adiós ni despedida en su momento. Pero entiendo que estaremos juntos en el cielo. Si pudiera sentir siento, si yo pudiera entender lo que habla el viento, sería alguien diferente.
siento. Si yo pudiera entender lo que habla el viento.
Good evening. Welcome back to the show. Phone lines are full on a Monday night. Paris Share. So we take your calls this evening, having you share your true encounters with the strange and the supernatural. Let's go to our longest waiting caller now, 38 minutes in. Tiffany in Pennsylvania, you are patient. Welcome to the show.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Doing great. What's your story for us tonight?
Well, I'll start with my very first experience.
Okay. Sounds good.
It was about back when I was living in California. It was before the 89 earthquake, so I was about 7 or 8, I think. And in my room, when I slept, I always slept on my stomach. But I always felt like this hot breath, like something was like blowing on my back. Now it wasn't a heater. I mean, because I didn't have any vents above my bed, but I always felt like this hot breath on my back. So one day I just got tired of feeling this breath, and I rolled over, and I fell back asleep on my side. Well, all of a sudden, I felt my leg just like somebody pushed my hip, and it literally pushed me over. So I roll on my bed, and now I'm laying on my back. And as I'm laying on my back, I can see into my bathroom area. Well, right there is this face. I mean, just talking about it right now gives